Hello guys, this is Pulsar 23 in-depth explanation series, and today we will talk about snare drum channel. So this is snare drum channel. It consists of a noise generator that have two modes, two sources. The first source is a usual analog pink noise generator. You hear it now, usual pink noise. And the second noise source is a digital spectral noise generator. You hear it now. And in second spectral noise generator you can adjust its spectrum using tune knob. So it has a wide palette of noise from separate crackles, as you hear now, up to white high, a kind of white noise. And also you have possibility to modulate this tune knob, modulate spectrum of this digital noise using this knob and using this input. And also you have a mix knob, so you can mix these two noises together, analog pink noise and digital spectral noise. So, as a second possibility how to make a timbre of snare drum, you have a resonance bandpass filter here. And using these four knobs, you can adjust timbre of your snare drum clap. So, if you wish to get clap, we have a special clap function here. So, while turning this knob clockwise, it adds additional slap that intrinsic to clap sound. Up to quite extreme time, that it's not a clap anymore, but a kind of experimental sound. So please note that this clap function works only if you trigger it with this sensor or via MIDI, but doesn't work if you trigger it via triggering input. So this is like a feature of this circuitry, so it's quite a complex system how to make this double slap. It works only these two sources and doesn't work if you use trig in pin. And also, of course, it has usual for all Pulsar channels attack adjustment. And release adjustment. Please know that the bandpass filter can work also as a generator, tonal generator, if you make resonance quite high. So using this modulation input, you can use it as additional tonal generator and turn pulsar into a tonal machine for pads, for soundscapes, and completely don't use it as a classical drum machine. So this is one of distinct features of pulsar, that it's very flexible and has very big range of sound palette that you can create on it, from classical analog drum machine to experimental noise pad soundscape machine that will have no anything similar with something that we can call drums. So I'm going to make a separate demo video devoted to these possibilities of pulsar, like a pad machine and soundscape machine. So also an important feature of this bandpass filter that it has a parallel structure. So in any settings of this bandpass frequency, you also can hear, you can also hear dry signal bypassed filter. So you can mix together dry signal, direct signal from the noise generator, and some frequencies emphasized by this bandpass filter. Now let's try to create some simple beat with snare drum channel. I will use the clock divider as a source for beats and use this pulse converter to create some simple straight beat like this. And now let's try to apply some modulation and make the sound more interesting. So first of all, let's try to modulate this spectrum noise using this pin and possibility to adjust amount of modulation. As a source for the modulation, I will use lower outputs of clock divider. So it will be in sync with the beat, but we'll have another timbre for each slap of this snare drum sound. Okay, let's try to add additional nuances in the sound using FX processor. So it's set it up in double delay, and I use very short delay time, so it sounds like a resonant filter, like a comb filter, more than like a usual delay. Let's hear. And let's try to modulate clock of FX processor using Sheos and make additional drifting of timbre. Okay, and let's add one more modulation to make the sound even more fluid using LFO divider, attenuator, voltage divider, and send the output of the voltage divider to input of the bandpass filter. Okay, now let's try some tricks, and I will show how to use a snare drum channel as a FX processor, something in between FX processor for external signal and snare drum module that use external sound as a noise source for its internal processing. So using quarter inch in, I put in Pulsar a sample from radio that I recorded some time ago. Let's hear it. So first of all, let's decrease all these effects. So let's make a kind of silence here and put external sound to the snare drum channel. And now let's hear how it works in this beat. Thank you. Okay, and let's now see how snare drum channel can use in unusual mode, and let's try to create additional hi-hat sound, so to have a kind of like double hi-hat with different chamber.